Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to IPW Dealer's Choice. My name is Terry Bailey, and I will be thing about Dealer's Choice is the fans got to pick some of the stipulations for the matches, but you guys are also going to pick some of the matches tonight. As you can see, we've got ourselves a raffle drum right here. We've got numbers in it. As you can see right here, here are the numbers of the people that are competing tonight. The only thing special about this is the one person's name who doesn't get chosen automatically gets a shot at the IPW Championship against Chad Alpha later tonight.
That's huge.
Look at him. We've got a couple of title matches as well.
All right.
The Michiana Championship will be on the line in the first match of the evening. And then in the main event, well, actually, right before intermission, we're going to have the women's title on the line. And you guys selected that to be a British Rounds match. Forgive me, I don't know what that is, so when it's time to do that match, I'm going to get my phone and I'm going to Google it, and I'm going to let you guys know the rules.
Chris, I'm going to try.
And then in our main event tonight, you guys selected, finally, House Bison must put the tag team titles up for grabs. They will face Mondo Real and Jimmy Hype Shaw in real life in a tables match. That is tonight's main event.
Some more of these guys' BS. As House Bison Good stuff.
Because I might get in trouble here because I'm seeing double. Two tag team champions.
Two champions.
It's about time.
It's a rarity.
I can't believe that.
It's a rarity.
Yeah. What's the last time we saw it?
I'm sorry. Nate's been busy opening up for Boys to Men all across the United States.
I told you.
We lost these tag team championships to Mondo Real and Max Morrison. So what do you have to do with this, Jimmy Shallon?
Freebird rules.
Huh?
Jimmy sucks! Freebird rules!
Big old 20-year vet. He's been around for a long time.
So he knows
time.
25, Junior.
Oh, 25. And who's been his right-hand man? For nearly all those 25 years?
Yeah.
What else? But Max Morrison right here.
That's true.
Max Morrison.
That is true.
And so all of a sudden, Jimmy Shallon loses his title.
No.
And these guys, they made a connection. And they had one of the greatest tag team title movies of all time. In comes Jimmy Shallon inserting himself. And who does he pick to be his tag team partner tonight to go for these belts? Is it the 20-year-old friend that has been there, right now outside, driving his bartender? You know this guy can put on the rooster. I'm just telling the truth right here. I'm telling the truth. You don't want to hear it?
He's trying to cause trouble. What he's doing.
Snowflake feelings.
That's your job. Leave him alone.
Anywho, so is it going to be the 20-year best friend, or is it going to be the new hot flavor of the month, high flying superstar Mondo Real?
Doesn't matter.
Look at him, Max. Look at Mondo right there. Is it like looking in the mirror? 20 years.
Did he just get to Max Morrison?
I hope he tortures Nate and makes you watch.
Anywho.
Yeah, let's go.
Yeah.
We love Max. You know
it's not happening. Not now.
Not you.
Never again.
You will never be loved.
Even if by some miracle, you guys take this down.
Very well.
We'll come back even stronger. No. But can you say the same for Three Harkin?
Nate doesn't need to show up. I'm going to come stronger. Nate ain't even here.
Play my music.
Listen to it. Bendrick Bison and the return of Nasty Nathan Sharp coming down here. And Dealer's Choice trying to cause problems with Three Harkin. And I'm listening to this. I know that's not how it goes, but if someone looking on the outside in is listening to all this, he might have some kind of point there, but I doubt it. We know Jimmy Hype Shawley. We know that's not how it is.
Three Harkin, baby.
Yeah! Oh, get that down.
Boys to Men.
What?
He's not even supposed to be around boys.
Oh. Or any kids, really.
Three birds, I'm going to use that.
Our main event tonight, the tag team championships are on the line. Three Harkin with Jimmy Hype Shawley and Mondo Real taking on House Bison here in Dealer's Choice.
stupid. Listen, nobody's gonna pick my opponent. Whoever he is, I'm gonna draw this opponent. You're sure as a lot better. I will choose who I'm going to wrestle.
Best of luck, Josh. It's good to see you again. I'm gonna go ahead and hold on to this.
Yeah.
13, whoever 13 is.
Reed. Little
Missy.
Can you believe it? The Honey Badger, Little Missy. Josh Raven's opponent tonight here at Dealer's Choice. And I wonder how everything's going to work out with Terry Van Avery and the Wings over here. Here she comes, the new IPW Cyber Champion. Just acquired it this past weekend. Earlier this weekend, I should say. Champion, Little Missy the Honey Badger. She actually eliminated Josh Raven in that battle royal to win the IPW Cyber Championship. And I'm sure he's got some kind of revenge on his mind. I don't like this matchup. I'm sure Josh Raven is full of glee. You can tell. The villainous Josh Raven.
So this kind of works out. 2 days ago, I was in a battle royal with this broad.
Whoa! Oh,
come on.
I was about to win, and she cheated. She cheated me out of the Cyber Championship. So this works out pretty good today.
Is this
cheater?
No,
this
is yours.
Yes.
Listen, that belt's on the line, my belt's on the line, I'm not worried about it. You guys know who's gonna win this match, right? It's a man versus a woman, let's be real here.
Not you.
All about equality. Alright, let's go.
Oh, you suck, John.
Alright.
Here we go.
Ring the bell!
And the bell has rung. It's Lil Missy, the Honey Badger. Josh Raven, the IPW Michiana champion, going toe to toe here at Dealer's Choice. What a day. The Michiana Championship is on the line. In case you didn't know, they lock horns. Here we go. You might think, oh man, Josh Raven's got the edge on this one. He's a little nasty. He really knows how to get things done. And then Lil Missy, the Honey Badger, has a vicious streak. And she can rip shit off just as well. Josh Raven's going to be paying attention to her. This broad is easy. So eloquently put it. You can't cheat in a battle royal, Josh Raymond. It's just not one of those things. Here we go. Cowboy, one, two. No. We almost had a new Michiana champion right there. Look at this. Yeah, he better be careful what he's saying to her. Lil Missy will rip your ass. Referee Chris on duties for this first matchup of the evening here for Dealer's Choice. And the fans think Josh Raymond sucks. The IPW faithful. Here we go. We're going to lock horns again. Oh, wait a minute. He wants to talk to referee Chris.
Hey,
get the hell out of here. Just like she cheated in the battle royal to win too, right?
No!
Did she pull your mustache?
Hair?
I did not pull the pre-mustache.
once again. Missy, reverse it. Josh Raymond reverses it. Raising the roof now in the ring here, Dealer's Choice. On the September 8th, 2024. Little Missy can be leaving double champion here tonight if things go her way. Locking horns once again. Waist lock applied. Takes him down. You gotta stay on Josh Raymond. He's a vicious dude, though. Little Missy's got some viciousness in her as well, but Josh Raymond does not care. He will do whatever it takes to hold on to that championship and hurt people, too, by the way. Little Missy making Josh Raymond look like a bit of a chump here tonight in the early goings of this first matchup in Dealer's Choice. Side headlock applied by Josh Raymond. Missy pushes him off. She comes back. Shoulder block. Takes her down. Feeling like a big man in the ring there, aren't you, Josh? Unbelievable. Here he goes. Missy Rolls trips him off. I love that. She just started adding that into her repertoire in the ring, and I love it. Keep doing that, Missy. Get him. Big splash in the corner. Raymond's down. Here she comes. Raymond ready for her, though. Moves out of the way just in time. Oh! Drops her right on her face. Here we go. Oh, jeez. Jeez Louise. Not good. Raymond with a look of glee in the eyes. In facial area. Yes, boo this man, please. Josh Raymond is used to it, though. He doesn't care. He doesn't faze. Josh Raymond one bit. Loves it, in fact. He loves to get under the skin of the IPW faithful. He loves to get under the skin of his opponents, the referee, Terry Van Avery, who is not enjoying one moment of this matchup whatsoever. This is bullshit, ref. Come on. Five count or not, he should know better. Come on, ref. Initiated, breaking it four, and disqualified in five.
You are weird. You are weird. You are weird.
That was pretty strange.
You are weird.
They
you
may have something
weird.
Here. It's champion versus champion in this first match.
You suck, Josh.
He thinks Missy's just gonna run over.
on.
You don't know missing that towel.
It's over, baby.
Not this rap. Not this rap. Not this rap. I'm this shit too, just like the last guy. Take what you get. So a couple of quick announcements before the next match. We've got t-shirts over here, $20 a pop. We've also got the raffle tickets, $1 a pop. The prizes for the raffle, considering you've got a lot of regulars in here, I recognize a lot of you people. We're going to do something special today. We're going to do two t-shirts instead of just one today. So two people who get a winning ticket are going to get a free t-shirt. And two people who get a winning ticket are going to get a picture in the ring with the wrestler of their choice from tonight. Just make sure that you come up to the second of the show. We're not going to come looking for you, obviously. You come find them. We've also got some concessions over there. We've got Pepsi, we've got Sprite, looks like we got some chips. And we've got a birthday boy in the audience tonight. So we got some birthday stuff over there. I think that's free. Right?
Not to say that.
Yeah, so make sure that you go over there, make some purchases, have a good time.
What's the birthday boy's name? How old is he turning?
I don't know. Yeah. I was just told there's a birthday boy. Don't put this on me.
You're supposed
Whose
to
birthday is it? Raise your hand. Come here. All right, young man, what's your name?
Yosef.
Say it again.
Yosef.
And it's your birthday today. How old are you?
Six.
Say it again.
Six.
How long have you been an IPW fan?
20 years.
He's been an IPW fan for 20 years, ladies and gentlemen.
Me too, pal. I love that kid. Happy birthday, buddy.
All right, young man, go have a seat. I might call you up here later again for something else.
20 years.
So, for our first match of the evening, we are going to have a fan come up here and pick two numbers.
Yeah.
Those two numbers are going to get it on.
Yeah! Good people up here.
So who are we picking? Who are we picking?
No,
you bring your hands up first, get over here. Next time, raise your hands quick.
This is a what's up the file. Mama be playing.
Pick two names right now. Spin it. Pick two names.
Pick two names.
Spin it. Pick two numbers. Let's go.
Hurry up.
We need birthday boy verified. Birthday boy verifies.
Right there. Boom.
You don't need your hundreds. Huh?
What's the first number?
What happened?
23. 23, that is. CJ Cole, and he will wrestle against.
Okay. He's been wrestling fast.
75.
Next man.
Ladies and gentlemen, we've got CJ Cole versus LeBron Sanders.
Yes! Yes! What a matchup this is going to be. The returning CJ Cole and the Don Sanders in the middle of an IPW ring tonight. This is going to be amazing. This is one we've needed for a long time. Fresh.
One ball.
One ball.
Introducing first.
Tonight, thank you, IPW Faithful, and that young man for pulling out those two names, CJ Cole and LeBron Sanders, going toe-to-toe here tonight. Never seen this matchup before. This is cool. What a treat this evening. Dealer's Choice. Thank you, Meet Pablo. Thank you to our friends at Lancaster, the Camp Insurance Agency as well.
His opponent.
I'll take
making his way to the ring, saying what's up to the IPW faithful along the way. And the Dot Center's going head to head with CJ Cole here tonight. Thanks to you, the IPW faithful, you're picking up the matches tonight. You're picking the stipulation. This is pretty fresh. In a brand new matchup here at IPW, never seen this before. These two, it's about to go down. This is the referee. Our second match of the evening here for IPW Dealer's Choice.
Now watch that chain. No chain for CJ. Don't make LeDoc kick his ass.
Check LeDoc Sanders. Never cheats. Never does anything messed up in the ring. But we never check Josh Raven. They don't get it. Didn't use the chain this time, though. Used the chair. Here we go. Yes, sportsmanship at its best. We just expect anything less from these two gentlemen right here. In the ring as we lock up. Collar and elbow tie up. The Don. In control. Wrist lock applied. You know what's next. CJ Cole. About to get clapped, brother. Nobody enjoys that. Having some fun in the ring. LeDon always knows how to have fun, but LeDon knows how to get it done as well. CJ Cole, apex athlete. Took it in good stride. Applies his own wrist lock here, though. LeDon slipping through with a side headlock, though. Hit to the midsection. Backs him up and throws. Throws him off. Trips over CJ. CJ with a leapfrog. The Don. These dudes are quick. Stopped LeDon for a second, then ran at him. LeDon gets out of the way. Here's a leapfrog. Look at these guys. Look at this. We're tumbling here tonight in IPW. Dealer's Choice. Speed-wise, these guys are evenly matched.
CJ's okay, but we got LeDon. CJ's okay.
Charging at LeDon again. LeDon ready for head scissors takeover. LeDon though. Not seen anybody ever do it like that before. LeDon, an amazing athlete. So CJ Cole. CJ. Takes the head scissors takeover. Which stride. These guys are evenly matched here. The quickness. Of both gentlemen, yeah. Respect, big time. CJ Cole, a little bit quicker right there with the response. Arm drag. Oh, double stop. Cover.
Just one.
One count only.
Come on.
Trying to get the crowd into this one. But LeDon Sanders. Forever favorite here at IPW. I don't know if anybody can match his popularity, honestly. Here we go, send him up for a suplex, perhaps. LeDon blocks. LeDon holding that block. Rolls him over. Two, no. Kick to the midsection. Sweeps the legs. LeDon a little dazed there. CJ Cole. Went for a code red. Didn't get it. Sunset flip takeover anyways. LeDon. Sling blade.
Come on, LeDon.
Let's go.
Nails it. Looking to finish this. Flips him over.
Come on, LeDon.
Snap suplex with a bridge there. Cover. Two. No. Dealer's Choice. Richland, Michigan, September 8th. Thanks for being here on Patreon. Thanks for coming to the show tonight, too. I'm going to be faithful. Both men evenly matched, giving it right back to each other throughout the duration so far. At IPW Dealer's Choice, thanks to the fans, we might not have gotten this match if it wasn't for you. Madonna looking to kick the head off, catches him with a super kick though. Falls over, cover.
The ring. We're gonna have to move it over, so
let's go
with that. You can't just get
there. CJ Cole now rolling onto the ring. Trying to catch a break here. With Don wondering what he has to do now. The ref checking out CJ Cole. Is he okay? Can you continue?
The Don's already doing a great job, man.
The Don looking to end this. It's cheek clapper time. No. Gets out of the way just in time. Here comes CJ Cole now. Sweeps his legs. Rushes in real quick. Here we go. Powerbomb. Just launched it too. Now CJ Cole looking to wrap things up. With a flying enziguri. Goes to cover one. Wondered where he's at. The Don is going to want to get this over with sooner than later, though. CJ Cole will surprise you real quick. Triple X Factor from LaDon Sanders. Turns him over to the cover. Two. No. He gets out at two. Kicks out at two. CJ Cole still in this thing with LaDon Sanders here at Dealer's Choice, Richland, Michigan. Thank you, IPW Faithful, for coming out, for watching on Patreon, for helping us decide these matches and the stipulations here tonight. Can he clap those cheeks? CJ Cole ready. Now CJ Cole, a house of fire. Whoa, missile dropkick. Excuse me, shotgun dropkick. Kip up, knee to the face. Side headlock applied. Bulldog from CJ Cole, the Apex athlete cover. Two. No. And CJ Cole can't believe it, but you better believe it. But Don doesn't go down that easy. And it's just been certain times and different circumstances. And I really can't put my finger on it, but in some way, shape, or form, the Don should have been IPW champion a long time ago, honestly, in my opinion. He's come so close. He's taken on some of the biggest and the best here he's ever graced an IPW ring, or entering, really. The Don with the strength now. What's he going to do? Hoist him up on his shoulders now. Spinning him around. We're getting dizzy. Oh. With a cutter. Cover. Two. No. Oh, he was so close. That was 2.99 seconds there. CJ Cole barely getting out of this predicament.
The wrestle guys, come on.
And LaDon Sanders trying to keep this IPW faithful on his back to bring him to the front. promised land to bring him to victory here tonight against CJ Cole at Dealer's Choice as he climbs to the second turnbuckle now.
Sorry, CJ.
He said he's sorry. No, triple X factor. No way. CJ Cole ready. Drops him. Picks him back up. CJ Cole, cover. One, two. No. Wow. This one is too close to call tonight between these two. Very evenly matched this evening here in Richland, Michigan. And Dealer's Choice with Independence Pro Wrestling. And CJ Cole wondered himself, what does he have to do to pick up the victory here tonight? Looking to the faithful. As he backs into the corner, LaDon's out. You gotta stay on LaDon. Do not give him a chance to rest. He may capitalize on that, and it could be let down for you. Misses. LaDon. Cheap clapper. Pulls him over. Cover. Great to have him back. Continuing to clap cheeks. Major opponent right there, CJ Cole. The Don Sanders victorious. Now that you know, see, these guys don't have a problem with each other. They can do their thing. They can get in the ring and they can rip shit up and be cool with each other after the match. There's no funny business. Respect here tonight at Dealer's Choice with CJ Cole and LaDon Sanders. The Quakeness evenly matched here this evening. That was awesome to see. Dealer's Choice.
Some of you guys were complaining that you thought that was rigged, right?
Right.
You guys thought it was rigged.
Plan.
You thought that it was
plan. 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 Plan.
If you guys think, if you guys think that he was a plant, fine. You guys pick who draws the next two.
Birthday boy.
You pick.
Terry's pissed.
Birthday boy. Birthday boy. Birthday boy.
Here's what you're gonna do,
young man. We never seen you before.
You're gonna twirl this, right?
Yes. Have you twirl it?
You're gonna pull it up on his forehead, and you'll reach in and pull a number out, and then we'll do it again, okay?
All right, he's spinning it right now. Are you going ready to stop? Boom, he stopped.
What is it?
Go ahead and pick a number out of there. This one. This one.
The kids are playing.
A baby plan.
What's the number, young man?
I don't know.
He's 6 years old.
I don't know. Numbers.
We've got.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know my numbers.
See, I told you.
I got it.
We've got number six. So somebody's got to wrestle Invictus.
Whoa! Someone's gonna die.
Go ahead and spin, young man. Let's see who the victim, I mean, opponent is.
I got it.
Go ahead.
No pressure.
34.
34.
Kevin.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Who's wrestling Invictus?
The next matchup will be Invictus versus Jarris Gray.
Whoa.
Give me just a moment, please.
Another matchup I never thought I would see anytime sooner, ever, really. And this is really exciting. Invictus the Monster. Jairus Gray, who's been back about a month and a half now here in IPW. Really doing some big things and looking awesome every time he gets in that ring. The White Wolf takes on Invictus next here at IPW. Dealer's Choice in Richland, Michigan on this September 8th, 2024. Thanks for being with us here on Patreon. Thanks for coming to the show.
We're getting your camera together. Everybody give a round to Justin over there with the camera. He does such a great job. For those of you who are subscribed to Patreon, Justin is recording all the best angles, and you can subscribe to Patreon now.
Get the Patreon.
For $3.99.
I got it. You got to give it to him.
Stuff back. The whole IPW library is on there, and those of you who were able to make picks on the matches, you know, you've been to Patreon. Anyway,
I picked the tables match on Patreon.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall.
One fall!
Introducing first.
Jairus Gray. He's happy. He's not scary. He's in a great mood. I love that new IPW t-shirt, too, by the way. Jairus Gray, the White Wolf, back here in IPW. Odds were not in his favor tonight, though, but I know he doesn't care. Gray will fight anybody, and tonight he fights Invictus, and it will be a fight. More like survival for Jairus Gray. Hopefully he can pull it off. Referee, doing a check over of Gray real quick. We still don't check out, we still don't check over Josh Raymond, though. I don't get that, Chris. Invictus only sees red. Invictus wants everyone dead. And Jairus Gray starting, his smile's gone now. Looking a little concerned. As we get into our third match of the evening here at Dealer's Choice in Richland, Michigan.
He doesn't understand anything, Chris. You can't talk to him. He doesn't understand.
I would be careful. I don't care if you're in the audience, if you're one of the faithful. It doesn't matter. You don't want to mess with Invictus. As Jairus Gray is finding out right now, he wasn't even trying to mess with Invictus. He just had his number pulled to be a part of this match here tonight. And now he's taking punishment big time from Invictus. That rope burn all across his face now. Thrusting that shoulder into the midsection of Jairus Gray, the White Wolf.
Get him out of the corner.
Who cares? Let him.
Victus doesn't care about the rules. Now he's blatantly choking him in the corner. Count of four. Four makes it to five. Don't get disqualified. Gray in bad shape now. Invictus now just having his way. Sets him to the other side of the ring. Follows him in. Big lariat to follow. Picks him up. Sidewalk slam from Invictus. Cover. Two. No. The monster, Invictus, recently, well, since he ever showed up here, has had problems with Dragon Jones. Now with Big Jorge. How's this all going to work out? Invictus wants both these guys done. He wants to end them. Jairus Gray making a comeback now. Jairus Gray, a wily individual. Knocks him back with a pretty amazing kick. Invictus is down. It's hard to get that guy down as well, or even Davis. That's where he's at right now, but if anybody can do it. It's Jairus Gray feeling the flow once again. Going to get back into this thing. Trying to recuperate himself still. The monster, not even fazed by Jairus Gray. Waist lock now. The big waist right there. Reverses it. Drops him down.
Jairus, be safe.
No, Wolves don't quit.
Now with a cross face. And that arm tied back. Looking to submit Jairus Gray, perhaps. A crossface applied, looking to submit his opponent, Invictus, looking to tear that head right off the shoulders there, I'm sure, of Jairus Gray. Gray fighting back now, trying to get some strength, some elbows to the midsection now. Invictus ready for him, just throws him down like trash. Stomp to the small of the back now. Looking to do some damage. Looking to destroy. I think that's all that's on this guy's mind. Blatant choke right in front of the ref. Ref with the 4-5 count. Picks him up. The strength of Invictus now. No. Jairus Gray. Fights out of it. Knocks Invictus down. By sheer chance. Goes to the ropes. Not sure if he can pull. Oh, he got him this time. Clotheslines him down. Invictus. Invictus is on his knees now. Jairus Gray, middle turnbuckle, now to the top. Slips. Turns himself around. He's going to fly. But Invictus is ready for him. Just throws him right off. Like a sack of potatoes. Clubbing blows to the back now by Invictus. Hitting hard here tonight. Hitting hard every night. Invictus, a scary individual, a monster. Drapes that throat right over the top of that rope now. Jairus Gray in trouble.
He don't quit. He's okay.
Referee checking on Gray now. Invictus biding his time. A menacing look. Nails him. Gray's down. Cover. Two. No. Got him. Jairus Gray poking the bear now. A little pissed off.
Got you!
I better. Whoa! Jairus Gray getting his before he leaves. I'd run out of there though. When this guy gets up, you don't want to be around. If I'm the referee, I'm getting out of the ring. Invictus pissed off. Now he's got one more man on the list, one more name with Dragon Jones and Big Jorge. Jairus Gray, what did you just do? Invictus, victorious here tonight at IPW Dealer's Choice. Are you missing out? IPW's basic Patreon subscribers have access to full IPW event replays, but only IPW regular tier members have access to premium matches for each event. Members of the IPW fan club have chances to win free merchandise, and IPW super fans get IPW merchandise delivered directly to their door. Don't miss out. Upgrade your membership today.
We are going to do one more drawing out of here. Those people will swear off whoever doesn't get picked is the lucky winner tonight, and they get a shot at the IPW Championship in the match after this one coming up.
Linda wants to pick.
Not really. Come on. Come on.
You're going to spin it. I'll pull it up, and you pull the number out, and we'll see who's wrestling who.
Ready to go? Pull one out.
Pull it out.
We've got number one. That will be
KC
Tempest.
The hardcore hero, KC Tempest. Who will be his opponent tonight?
It doesn't matter. KC versus it doesn't matter.
All right.
KC shot it.
And the opponent is.
KC, no. Dragon Jones.
He's dropping.
Who? What? What? Huh?
Our opponent will be number 10. That is Max Morrison.
KC Tempest versus Max Morrison here tonight. IPW Dealer's Choice. Your pick of the matches. Your pick of the opponents.
We might have forgot to mention this, but anybody who wrestles KC Tempest, you know what it's going to be, right?
Hardcore!
That's right, damn it. Hardcore!
Handle hardcore. Should handle hardcore.
And Max Morrison?
Max is okay.
With KC Tempest?
Yeah, Max is our
former brethren of the Forgotten.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall.
Hardcore!
And it is a hardcore match.
Yeah!
Figured you'd get a better shot right there than me.
And making things worse in this man's life right now with the comments that were made, considering Three Hearted and Jimmy Hutchall. He's already dealing with this Nazareth bullshit. And then Bendrick Bison had to stir the pot. Here we go. Morrison has something to say.
Casey, former forgotten member again.
Oh no,
that's not. You know, only weeks ago, I got to step in the ring with Jarrus Gray. And all of you know how that ended up. But don't misunderstand me. I'm not underestimating you tonight. You're a whole different KC Tempest than I remember.
And you're a different match.
All that face paint gone.
Gone.
All the hardcore.
Hardcore.
Believe me, I wasn't ready for that tonight. You're not the opponent that I wanted.
You'll take it.
Come step here to me. Look me right in the eye. You know who I was looking for tonight.
Yeah.
And I said I was going to take everything from that guy. And he didn't even show up tonight.
Never does. Never does. Never does. Never does.
And he continues to look over his shoulder.
I'm not taking you lightly.
No.
Cross my heart.
That's right.
Thank to God.
All to die.
This will be an interesting match. Watch out, KC! Bell hasn't even rang yet. This is hardcore, though. Max Morrison is so just disturbed right now by everything that's going on with Nazareth, with Real Hype, Three Hearted, and that whole tag team thing. KC Tempest delivering hard blows now, going for the cover. This is a hardcore match. Watch out, toys will be introduced into this match at some point, I'm sure. And if I'm Max Morrison, I'm grabbing the chair right away and I'm coming after him. You have to. You got to stay on Casey Tempest. The dude's a machine, but at the same time, Casey Tempest. Oh, there he goes. Casey's got his chair. Max Morrison is kind of a dangerous individual right now, more dangerous than usual. This is with that chair shot. Clubbing blows to the back of the neck and head area. He picks up the chair, gives it to Casey right in the back. It's all legal. The only way to win is to pin or submit your opponent inside of the ring. Everything else goes. No holds barred, hardcore. Extravaganza coming your way. Hanging from the rafters, Max Morrison. Flies! Crossbody. Two. No.
Just two.
And Max Morrison. Really disturbed more than ever before, especially tonight with that whole incident. That whole. He just walked right out of the ring, too, at the beginning of Dealer's Choice. Misses the chop. Casey back on the attack now. Bust him right in the face.
Oh, shit. Can't do that again.
Come on, man.
Stumbling into the ring. Stumbling around in the ring. Now Casey going underneath the ring. Grabs a cookie sheet. Smells like somebody's baking brownies. Oh, damn it. Look at that. What is that? Cookie sheets. Nails Max Morrison again when it goes for cover one. Two. You gotta capitalize on Max every time. Put him down. The wily veteran. It's a little bit more of a dangerous place these days as well. Casey going back outside under the rope. Nope, grabbing a chair. What else does he want? He wants another chair. Give him another chair. Somebody. Again, you're going for all these weapons and such, and I know it's all well and good, but you gotta stay on Max Morrison. Morrison knows how to win. He knows how to win championships. He knows how to play hardcore. He knows how to fight just about anybody, really, though. Oh, look at that. He was ready for him. Nailing Casey Tempest. Really going to take out all his frustrations on KC tonight, I'm sure of it. All because of Nazareth. All that bullshit that Bedrick Bison was spewing at the beginning of Dealer's Choice as well. Here we go, cut the sheet to the head. No, that's the road sign. This is the do not enter. That's what happens when you enter. Metro World of Pain. Max Morrison bringing it to Casey Tempest. What's he gonna do with that chair? That's what I love about these guys. They get in here, they get so creative with the hardcore tactics, with the weapons, and how they're gonna use them, and what they're gonna do to their opponent, and how badly they're gonna make him hurt. He knows how to swing a chair. Here we go.
Here's the big one, Casey. Are you ready?
Line him up, tell him this is it. This is the big one, buddy. Right in the head. Nails him. Casey Tempest could be out.
Casey's tough.
Referee checking on him.
Let's go.
Casey, tough.
Stacking up some chairs in a certain particular kind of way. What's he gonna do here? What's Max Morrison have planned? Going back underneath the ring for some reason.
Casey's tough. Casey's tough.
What the hell is that?
Casey's tough.
Is that some kind of glass? There's some kind of glass there. What the hell is that? It's a TV, damn it.
Get up, Casey.
Where the hell did the TV come from? Who put their TV under the ring? Morrison now. Pounding away on Casey Tempest. He's totally dazed. And confused about where he's at right now. Comes in hard. Max Morrison. Suplex. And Casey Tempest hardcore match. Anything goes here tonight at IPW Dealer's Choice. Thanks to you, the IPW faithful, coming out, picking the opponents, picking their stipulations. Max Morrison going to the top rope, grabbing the rafters. Casey ready for him though. Sneaks up on him, drops his jewels on those ropes there, and Morrison feels it, and it's not feeling good.
Can't see what you're doing.
It's all right.
Bringing him back up, maybe for a superplex, perhaps. Casey Tempest superplex on Max Morrison. Tax is feeling the pain now.
Right.
We're
no Tax. Not yet.
You're fine.
Yes, he knows he's got hit. He can't rest on this one. He's got to get Max out of this. You give Max a chance to rest up a little bit, you're in trouble.
TV.
Tempest. Knows how to use it, damn it. Casey Tempest coming back up the ring now. He needs all the toys out. Everyone's got that one dog. He goes to the toy basket. What the hell is that? A ball bat. It is pretty sparkly there. He's got thumbtacks in it, perhaps. Like they're super glued.
What is
Morrison ready though? Do not enter. Grabs the chair. Morrison. Oh damn it! He fell through that TV.
Holy shit! Holy shit!
Tempest in a world of hurt now.
Holy shit!
He saw Morrison. Morrison saw Casey Tempest with that gnarly looking bat. He said, "Hell no! That's not happening to me tonight." Bump these guys, beating the hell out of each other here. IPW Dealer's Choice. Thank you, Lancaster Camp Insurance Agency, and me, Pebble, for being part of this thing we call Independence Pro Wrestling.
Watch out.
It's been a big weekend for IPW. Our second event this weekend. Morrison rolls KC back into the ring. Top turnbuckle now. Gonna drop that elbow, I'm sure, right to the heart of Tempest. No, Tempest gets out of the way. Morrison now looking good. Gonna fracture that elbow right there. He landed real hard. He was gonna put that elbow deep into Casey Tempest's heart. Casey could feel it, he got out of the way. Casey goes back up to the outside. Grabs a chair. That chair looks pretty gnarly itself. Been all beaten up. Bodies going through it. It going through bodies. Drops him.
Oh, Jesus.
This could be it for Max Morrison. As he goes for the cover. One, two, got it. Former forgotten members in a hardcore match. Casey Tempest comes out on top this evening. It's not been a good couple of months here for Max Morrison here in IPW with the return of Jeremiah Nazareth. He's so totally distracted about what's going on with that. He wants it bad though. He wants to end this Nazareth thing. Well, we've been seeing a lot of creepy videos coming out of that cult lately. And it's scary. Casey Tempest, your winner here tonight. IPW Dealer's Choice. The hardcore hero. Referee Chris now checking on Morrison.
Careful.
Final few minutes of this match just decimated by Casey Tempest. Does he know where he's at now? A little wobbly there. May need some help to the back. His 300 brethren have a big match tonight. undefeated here in IPW. And he gets a shot at the championship just because this is the last name left in the little tumbler there that they've been using tonight to pick out matches, to pick out opponents tonight for IPW's Dealer's Choice. That's right. It was because of you, the IPW faithful. You helped pick the stipulations tonight. But he's got a tall test in front of him with the IPW champion, the specimen, Chad Alpha. The most fightingest champion ever in IPW. I mean, Chad Alpha pretty much makes his own matches. He's challenging people like unbelievable here in IPW. He said, hey, you want a chance at my title? You want a shot? Bring it. I don't care who you are. As long as you deserve it. As long as you got some kind of streak going along. As long as you're out there fighting yourself. And you're giving these fans what they want. And you're busting your ass here in IPW. I'm going to give you a shot. So I'm sure he has no problem with taking on Armando Alvarez here tonight. The big step up from New Orleans, Louisiana. Can you imagine here tonight, new champion Armando Alvarez? What a coup it could be here tonight in Dealer's Choice. Luck of the draw, this kid gets the championship match here tonight. A lot of confidence there in this young man. Alpha says, hell no.
You're going to learn today. You're going to learn
today. Alpha, the IPW faithful. Gilly Alvarez. Some shit right now. Let's do it, guys. Championship match, IPW title on the line here at Dealer's Choice. The specimen, Chad Alpha. The big step up, Armando Alvarez. Looking to lock horns here in Richland, Michigan, USA. On the September 8th for Dealer's Choice, Lancaster DeCamp Insurance Agency. Me, Pablo, thank you for being along on the ride of this IPW freight train. We just keep rolling. Test of strength. This kid's got something up his sleeve, and he doesn't even have any fucking sleeves. He's pulling some bullshit right now with the champ. Alpha's a no-nonsense kind of guy, though. Side headlock with the trickery. See, didn't even phase him. He took that to the midsection. This guy works out, damn it. Throws him. Just throws him like a small child across the ring. No timeouts in pro wrestling is right. Locking horns. Side headlock. The champ. In control. Just grinding. Alvarez looking to get out of this predicament. Some shots to the midsection there. Wrist lock. Side headlock now of his own. Applied. Armando Alvarez, the big step up, catches an atomic drop from the champ. Sends him in the corner. This kid's in pain. Here comes Alpha. Big shoulder. Alpha hoists him up. Look at Alpha. Cover. One, two.
Just two.
No. Minus up some more.
And most champions would be like, I want to know who I'm facing tonight. Alpha doesn't even care. Alpha hardly ever knows who he's facing half the time. So he's waiting for somebody to shoot their mouth off with him and make a challenge. He's all good with it. Doesn't mind one bit. Now the faithful of IPW telling Alvarez to get back in the ring. The big step up. Step your ass back in, buddy. The champ's waiting.
That's why I stopped.
Alpha comes charging hard. Hoists him up once again. Look at the strength of Alpha. Gorilla Press drops him. Alpha back on the tack. Knees to the midsection. Has him in the corner there. Sends him to the other side of the ring. Follows in. Misses. Alvarez ready for him. Goes for a cover. One. Alvarez very smart in that way. Capitalizing on that. You see a guy go down like that in any way, shape, or form that's way bigger than you, you got to stay on him. Especially as the champion. You want to be that guy. You want to hold that title here at IPW. Big stop there to the midsection by Armando Alvarez. Goes back for another one. Oh, a slap this time. Insulting the champion with a slap to the face. You're just going to piss Alpha off. That's one of those guys, friendly guy. I love hanging out with Alpha. I love seeing Alpha backstage and everything, interviews, whatever. Very pleasant guy, but you piss him off, you cross him just the slightest. Like I said earlier, he's a no-nonsense guy. Takes a European uppercut right there from Alvarez. And then Zaguri drops Alpha. Alpha, not seen Alpha in this position in a long flipping time. Pulls him out to the middle of the ring. Oh, not so much to the middle of the ring, but there he goes, Alpha. Right close to that rope, but was able to kick out. Get that shoulder up, if you will. And save the match for himself. Save the championship. Alvarez now choking Alpha on that middle rope.
We still ref. Got Alpha. You still suck, bro. You still suck.
Applies the five count. Breaks it. Alpha, there you go. There comes that no nonsense. Wow, what a forearm. Now they're giving it back and forth. And no disrespect to Alvarez, but man, Alpha's forearms are way bigger. And hit a lot harder. Big drop kick from the champ. Alpha. Measuring up Alvarez, scoops him up. In position. Running power slam from Chad Alpha, the IPW champion. Ring awareness though from Mr. Alvarez. Catches his foot right up there on the rope, saves the match for himself. Alvarez could pull this off tonight in the right circumstances like that. Pull some dirty shit like that. Here we go, neck breaker. Cover. One, two, Alpha kicks out. Fans not happy with Alvarez's tactics. As he continues to mock the fans, to goat them. Now, to nail. Oh, Alpha, no. Alpha catches him. Alpha turns it around. Alpha hoists him up. Yup, jackhammer, cover, two, got him.
Your winner and still IPW champion, the specimen, Chad Alpha.
Still your IPW champion, the specimen, Chad Alpha, victorious here at Dealer's Choice. On this September 8th, 2024 in Richland, Michigan, over Armando Alvarez. Continuing to steamroll over the competition here at IPW, taking on all comers, the fightingest champion ever in the history of IPW.
Introducing
first, the challengers.
A real awkward situation earlier this evening with Three-Hearted, Jimmy Hype Shaolin, Mondo Real, Max Morrison, and Bendrick Bison stirring the pot. You know, Morrison right now, already worrying about Nazareth, what he's got to do there, preoccupied. A lot of things going on in that head I don't think any of us could understand right now. And for him to come in here, talking about Bison, talk the shit that he did, and try to cause some dissension. Three-Hearted, not cool, man, but I get it. First title defense for the champions. Of course, they're going to do whatever it takes to hold on to those championships.
New champ. And their opponents.
They've been champions for a while now, and unbelievably, this is their first title defense. The bullshit that Bison spews sometimes, it makes me laugh at the same time. Like Nasty Nathan Sharp was out on tour with Boyz II Men all over the nation. Give me a break. If anything, he was carrying their bags, but I doubt that was even the case. We got Real Hype, one of the greatest, probably the greatest tag team ever in IPW history, challenging tonight House Bison for the IPW Tag Team Championships. Bison did bring up a good point earlier, though. How come it's not Max and Mondo challenging? They're the ones who lost it to House Bison. Thanks to Nazareth, damn it.
Because I can see the hair that you're holding on to. Guess what?
Referee convening with the champs now, grabbing those titles. He's got that damn keyboard with him. Of course, Real Hype. Can't wait to bring those home. Hopefully, they can make that happen here tonight at Dealer's Choice. This is a tables match for the IPW Tag Team Championships, by the way. No rules. There's actually one rule. The only way to win is for your opponent to go through the table. You must put your opponent through the table to win. There's no pinfalls. There's no countouts. There's no disqualifications. None of that. A submission won't help you win. A pinfall will not help you win. You must put your opponent through the table. And this is a tables match. Everything goes. Tornado style, damn it. You gotta love it when Real Hype can get real wild in the ring, especially against these two a-holes. Nasty Nate the Shark catches himself before knocking into Bendrick Bison. Oh, they get squashed though by Real Hype. Mondo Real, a real rock star. Jimmy Hype Shaolin, 25 years in the business. Makes wrestling fun like no other. just throws Nasty Nathan over his shoulder like nothing.
Yeah.
And he's got this look on his face tonight. I wouldn't want to be in a ring with him on the other side. Ed Hyde Shaolin means business tonight. He's pissed off. He's disappointed about how these guys, oh, backstabber. Pissed off. And he should be, everybody should be mad at House Bison. Not defending these titles. Not making wrestling, tag team wrestling fun. But just pulling bullshit and dumbass stipulations every time they come down for any kind of match. It's just really ridiculous. Double teaming on Hype now. Mondo Rios sees it. He comes. He goes. He's flying. Tope Suicido.
Come on!
And he's ready to rip shit up. House Bison is down. Things are looking real good for the former champions. It's real hype. It's House Bison. It's a tables match, and not one table has been introduced yet. You gotta be strategic about the tables. You don't want to set one up and not be ready to put your opponent through it, because something stupid can happen, and you can end up going through it yourself. And there you go. Title shot gone. Or maybe you're not retaining the title. Whatever the situation may be. Well, he's got one of those cupcakes. Big like Jimmy Shaolin with a cupcake. No rules. Right in your fucking face, Nasty Nathan. Socks him right in the gut. Nasty Nathan can't believe it. He's just rubbing that right in his face. He spits it out at Bison. Amazing. Put it in his mouth. Hit him in the back hard. And he spit it right at Bison. Oh! Mondo! Throwing Bison right into those chairs. There's no rules tonight. Yeah. That hurts. Now just squeezing the melon of Nasty Nathan. Fish hooking, it looks like. There's no rules. Do whatever you want. You just got to put your opponent through a table to win. Is all, look at his beet red chest. His whole body beet red.
Is that a cupcake?
These guys are getting their asses handed to him here tonight. IPW. Dealer's Choice. It's been a while since we've seen Nasty Nathan Sharp. I'm sure there's all kinds of rust from touring with Boys to Men. Can House Bison recuperate? Can they retain the titles tonight? As they make their first ever title defense here in Richland at Dealer's Choice with Independence Pro Wrestling. And the former champions with their X-Men gear on tonight. Oh, House Bison ready for real hype. Punishing now. Nasty Nathan, real weird dude, but he knows how to get the job done. Dude can wrestle, dude can punish, and he's doing that right now, blatantly choking. Doesn't matter though, the choke is legal. Big elbow to Hype Shaolin. Now kicking away, Bison in control. Stopping a mud hole. Nasty Nathan using his boot now to choke out Mondo Rio. Here comes a chair, all legal. Now choking Hype Shaolin. What's new? He always looks ridiculous. You see what he's wearing, dude? Look at what you're wearing. Big chop to Mondo from Bison. Bendrick Bison set up a chair for some reason. Something nasty is about to take place with these two. Double team maneuver from the champions, if you can call them that. Yeah, they technically they won the match months ago. Did they get help? Have they defended them once? Nope. So tonight, this is a real test for the champions. Can they earn it? Here we go, double team maneuver again. Hype completely dazed in the corner there, facing the turnbuckles. Mondo Real not looking good either right now. Nasty Nathan has a nasty swing with those chairs. Mondo ready for him, kicks him in the midsection, drops the chair. You don't want to go fist to cuffs with Hype Solomon though. Drops an elbow. Nasty Nathan now working over Mondo Rio. Throws Hype out of the ring. Hype. Here we go. Double team maneuver. No. Oh. Love that move. Drops the leg. No pinfalls, though. You got to stay on these guys. If I see Heights out of the way, if I'm the champs, I'm looking to grab a table real quick and get it set up, get it in position, and I'm putting Mondo through it while Heights, you know, out of the picture. Now the disrespect. Oh, he slams his face right into the canvas. Casio keyboard in sight. I'm surprised he hasn't whipped that out yet. Holding Mondo now. Double teaming the former champion.
Come on, Mike.
Nasty Nathan. Some nasty kicks. Concentrating on Mondo Real now. His house bison. Look at that. That maneuver. I don't think that worked out too well for Bendrick over there, though. Nasty Nathan looks fine. Mondo does not look good. Oh, wait. He's on a comeback. Throwing fists. Nasty throws him back. Throws Mondo out of the ring. We see Pipe on the apron there, trying to make his way back into the ring, trying to get back into the fight. Blocks. Throws a left. Excuse me, throws a right. My right, your left. Your left, my right. Here we go. I don't even know if Nasty Nathan can spell. Oh! Saw Bison get up and just shoves him right into him.
Where's the tables at?
Get the tables, he said. Where are they at? Hype's ready to get this over with. He's ready to become tag team champions again with Mondo Real. With Jimmy Hype Solomon. That is real hype.
I think they quit.
One of the greatest, probably the greatest tag team ever in the history of Independence Pro Wrestling. The first table sighting of the match. And this is a tables match. Look at that. Double drop kick. Nails the former champions. Hype takes a seat now. The champion setting up a table now. Like I said, you better be ready to use it if you're gonna set it up, because it could backfire on your ass. Setting up on those ropes there. They call him Blue Mouth. Nasty Nathan Sharp brings Hype back to the ring. Now both men, Bison and Sharp, pounding away, looking to put Hype through this table. This could be it. Nasty Nathan doesn't have the strength. Oh! With assist from Bison, they're gonna do it together now. Mondo saves Hype. Double noggin knocker. Drop kick. Takes a swing at Hype. Hype ready for him. Yeah, let's finish it. Nathan out of the ring now. Double team maneuver from the former champions. Real Hype. Looking to reclaim the IPW Tag Team Championships here tonight at Dealer's Choice. Reminding you, the former champions, Mondo Real and Max Morrison. I'm not trying to stir the pot either, but I don't know. Here we go, setting up that table. The former champions are ready to use this. Bison, Dane's, not sure where he's at, probably. Mondo grabs Bison, sets him, oh, bangs his head off the table there, sets him up onto it. Looking to finish things. Here we go, let's do it, guys. We need new champs. We need champs that we can be proud of. Oh, there's Nasty Nathan Sharp. Nobody's proud of him. Mondo Neal, back in the action now. Tacky, Nasty Nathan Sharp, big chop.
One more time.
We need champions who are ready to defend, like Chad Alpha. Like Josh Raymond, too, honestly. Not always a champ we can be proud of, but he'll get the ring and mix it up with anybody. And here we go, House Bison. Setting up that table in the corner now. Looking to retain tonight in their first title defense. And they've had the championships, let me reiterate, for months. For at least a couple of months throughout the summer. It's been unbelievable. Tag champs. Going to town, looking to finish things up. Looking to suplex hype from this table. Can they do it? Do they have what it takes? Hype fighting back big time though. Hype Shawlin. Looking to suplex his own, but hurts his back in the process. Ooh, Nasty Nathan almost lost his team the match. Clubbing blows with that axe handle smash in the back of Jimmy Hunt Charlotte. Now working over his back. Now they're going to smash his face into the canvas, I'm sure of it. Damn you guys. No rules. This has been a wild one. This tag team titles tables match here. IPW Dealer's Choice. You guys picked this one, though. You picked the stipulation. And I'm proud of you for it, IPW faithful. The chalice, there's nothing in it. What's he gonna do? It's okay, you can nail him in the head with it because there's no rules. The only rule is to put your opponent through the table to win the match. That's the only rule here tonight at IPW Dealer's Choice in this tag team titles tables match. Bendrick Bison wasting time now though. Wasting a lot of time. Mondo Real ready! Mondo Real puts Bison through the table! All right, Bison eliminated. Nasty Nathan immediately goes for his Casio keyboard. Hype blocks. Hendrick Bison eliminated. Nasty Nathan has to do this all by himself, and he's got a big feat to accomplish here. DDT. But there is a reason why they call him Nasty Nathan Sharp. Is it because of the tire? Isn't it because of the bad music that he produces? It's because he gets nasty in the ring. Nasty Nathan. Mondo Real on the apron now. Mondo hitting hard. Looking for a cutter. No. Nathan returns with a kick to the midsection. Setting him up. Looking to put him through that table right there. Can he do it? Mondo fighting hard. Here comes Hype Collins. Steering him down, big smile on his face. Get ready, damn it! Get ready! Here it is! It's a hype bomb! Look at that, there we go! It's done, it's over! Once again, tag team champions here at IPW, the greatest tag team champions of all time here at IPW. Jimmy Hype Shawlin, Mondo Real, a real rock star. Table smash successful. Congratulations to the new champs.
Real Hype, Real Hype, Real Hype, Real Hype, Real Hype.
Independence Pro Wrestling finally returns on Saturday, October 19th to Trinity Martial Arts for one of the biggest events of the year, our fifth annual Halloween celebration, Brave Danger. Dress up as your favorite IPW star and witness over 2 hours of hard-hitting, high-flying action, delicious food options available, and bring your own beverages. Tickets are available now on Eventbrite starting at just $20, and all ages are welcome. Join us on Saturday, October 26th for our longest-running annual pro wrestling showcase, Grave Danger 5.
Dude, Max, where you are? Hey, man. Oh, sorry. We did it, man.
Hey, congratulations.
Thanks, dude.
Got him back, baby.
Hey, dude. I know Bice was trying to get your head. You knew that. That's why you bounced. You just didn't want to be a part. Didn't want to be part of that whole thing. I appreciate that. But I do. We talked about it. We're bummed for you, man. We feel. We know you wanted to draw Jeremiah tonight. We know. You know that's who you wanted to wrestle. You're gonna get him. Don't worry. You're gonna get that douchebag cultist.
Whoa. Hang on. I have nothing to do. I don't want Jeremiah tonight. Don't worry, but there was a lot of numbers in that roller, okay? You'll know when I want you to know who I want to take it all from, okay? But let's be honest. I haven't exactly been the nicest guy in Three Hearted lately. Can we just be lighthearted about this?
I like it, man.
Yeah, whatever you say, man.
Don't you worry, guys. I got it all up here, okay? You just trust me.
All right, man.
Yeah. Ooh.